Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Earth Spirit.
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Assassin.
Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining. Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Dire team ban. Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Witch Doctor.
Dire team pick.
Juggernaut.
Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
My name is Tsunami, and I'll be joining you as we go through this. Vertispro versus Vega Squadron. So currently, Vertispro are the highest ranked in the division right now. They were undefeated earlier today, or at the end of yesterday, they were undefeated. They were 4-0. Now, I believe they played their fifth game while we were watching that Navi versus Comanche game, so let me actually see if they won or not.
Dragon Knight.
Dire team pick.
False alarm. This is VP's first game of the day. So they are currently undefeated. Vega Squadron are on the lower half of the standings right now. So they are up for grabs in terms of elimination. Which means that they are probably not... I don't know how good of a fight they'll give up to VP. Especially if VP is picking some crazy non-meta heroes like DK. Personally, I think DK is a very good hero. I think DK's talents are strong. In fact, let me take a look at them, because... Oops. So let's take a look here. The level 10 is 7 strength or 20 attack speed. Those are both good talents, especially for a Dragon Knight. Level 15 is plus 40 damage. Everyone was flipping out about Lone Druid's damage talent, but plus 40 damage for a carry at level 15, it's pretty good. Level 20, 120 gold per minute or 300 health, which if you go for the 7 strength and you go for the 300 health, that's what? 440 HP extra. And then 25, 2 times the Dragon Blood HP regen and armor, or 60 movement speed. 60 movement speed! And Dragon Blood, it'll be 24 armor and 24 health regen. I think this hero is very good. I don't know why more people aren't playing him. VP are playing him, and that has me excited, because since VP is the highest ranked right now, they are clearly a good team, and it's not just some random team picking a DK, it's a team that knows what they're doing. Solo, Ramses, Nolan, Pasha, and Lil on the VP squad. Arguably the favorites of the division. Given how the before the qualifiers even started, most people were considering VP the favorites. Some people were even considering VP direct invite material, which may be a bit of a stretch, but maybe if you took away VGJ's invite, maybe you could make an argument for VP. It's a tough call. But they're here now and they're doing well. And this game, banning out the Lone Druid and Centaur first phase, Vega Squadron banning out the Stargar and Ogre, and Radiant picking up a Darkseer, Earth Spirit, Witch Doctor, and of course the aforementioned DK. And Vega Squadron with Shadow Demon, Nyx Assassin, Juggernaut, Alchemist, and Lina. So most of the time DK is played in the mid lane, and especially with a Slark being the fifth pick for VP, it's a pretty safe bet that DK is going to be in the mid lane. But the unique thing about DK is that, unlike many of the other mids that we've been seeing these days, he doesn't really need a support babysitting him that much. Especially since one of the biggest things that Alchemist has as an edge is Acid Spray. And Acid Spray being dealing physical damage, and Acid Spray being an armor-dropping spell, is actually not that important against a Dragon Knight, because Dragon's Blood is going to be giving a lot of armor. Chances are DK will not have that many points in Dragon's Blood early on. If he skips Dragon's Tail or not is going to be the main question. So, if DK doesn't find it necessary that he's going to be playing aggressive early on, and easy to make some rotations on an Alchemist mid. But then that means that no one has to skill Dragon Tail early on, which means that he will not have either as many points in Dragon Blood or not any points as many points in Breathe Fire, and those are both very important spells for a DK. Sorry. So we'll see what he goes for. We'll see how aggressive Vega Squadron will be, how much health they'll be giving out this Alchemist. Lina, not necessarily the best babysitter. She's definitely not, like... In fact, I don't even know if Snake is going to be spending very much time in the mid lane. They may just want to be supporting this Juggernaut most of the time. We'll see. Obviously, Shadow Demon and Lina present a very strong roaming combination. Assuming they can pull off the combination. I've seen some less than stellar coordination in other teams. I haven't seen Vega try to pull off a roaming duo yet, so we'll see how it goes. We'll go through these lineups as usual. We've got Solo on the Witch Doctor. We've got Ramses on the Slark. We've got no one on the Dragon Knight. We've got Pasha on the Darkseer, and we've got a little... What the heck is this? Is this a set, or is it like... Yeah, no, he has like a bunch of random items. Demon's Ornaments? Oh, wait, no. It's the same set. It's the Demon's set or something. That's pretty crazy. Lil on the Earth Spirit, and on the Dire Team, we've got Seema on the Shadow Demon, we've got Mag on the Nyx Assassin, we've got G on the Alchemist, we've got Dichira on the Juggernaut, and we've got Seneko on the Lina. And it looks like Vega are going to go for an aggressive tryline, sending Dichira and Seema down here and Lina to join them. And Nyx Assassin is going to be solo in this top line, going up against a solo, or, well, we'll see how VP actually chooses to land this, because they're sending the Witch Doctor up here right now. Earth Spirit's still shelling the mid lane, but he's just going to be roaming. And they're going to send Pasha solo in the spot lane, so VP come out advantageous in this position, by far. They read the lanes correctly, and... While Shadow Demon and Lina do a pretty good job at killing Darkseer, that's only if they can ever get the jump on them. And I don't really know how much time Seema is going to be spending down here. Meanwhile, mid lane, we've got a rotation onto G. Lil has that Orb of Venom. And he's getting no one some valuable levels. And no one did take Breathe Fire at one. So he's going to take a ton of damage from the Assassin Spray, but might just use itself. Aw, Solo gets the last hit on the troll. This Ion Shell makes it so difficult to go aggressive because the lane is always going to be pushed. Steam is still looking around, has not gotten any experience, but Darkseer has gotten zero experience so far, so... The tri-lane is doing its job, but still, Pasha's getting passive gold. They run into Seneko. Puts up the Ion Shell. Seneko does not have very much move speed, but gets the LSA off. They continue chasing it down, but Pasha needs to back up. Unfortunately, Pasha went for the Soul Ring recipe right out of the base, and so it's not going to be very easy for him to transition into a Iron Talon if that's what he wants to go for. He's pretty committed to staying in lane now. But you don't need an Iron Talon. A Darkseer can still jungle just fine with the Soul Ring, or even just with some Stout Shield items. And yeah, he's circling up the jungle, so it looks like that's going to be the plan. And Dire Team have not blocked out any of these jungle camps, so this tri lane's not getting very much done. And Dragon is doing just fine in this mid lane. In the meantime, I'm going to get LSA by this hasted up Seneko. But it's still a level 1 Seneko. While Alchemist was picking up a bounty rune. And it looks like no one is going to be skipping up Dragon still. Since that those level 1 ganks didn't do very much to G. And the TP potential of Shadow Demon coming in and saving the Alchemist is too high. I understand why no one is just going for the farming build as opposed to wanting to maybe get a kill on an Alchemist. Seema hits level 2, has Soul Catcher. And now Seneko has hit level 2 off of this creep wave, but still, like, this tri-lane isn't getting anything done. Pasha has gone to the jungle. He's hit level 2, about to hit level 3. Slark is free farming. Both cores on both teams are free farming effectively, but at least Witch Doctor is getting some work done here. Which this may be the best way to take advantage of the tri-lane, is just to go for an early push. Dichira has healing ward, they can just cut the creep wave if they want, and just take a very, very early tier 1. And looks like that's what they're gonna do. Not even needing to use the healing ward. 4 minutes in, the first tier one goes down for VP. But I'm pretty sure they're okay with that. This makes it a little bit easier for Darksteer to farm. And it does give Nyx Assassin more access into the Radiant Jungle, but this Nyx Assassin isn't going to be able to get active once he hits 6, because then his tower is going to get pushed. So someone will constantly need to be in this top lane. It looks like Juggernaut's going to take it now that the bot lane is a little bit more difficult to farm, since it's going to be pushing in so deep.
Denied.
Looking like they want to go for rotation on no one, but this is a difficult gank attempt. And no one does take the dragon still at 5. Aggressive ward placed in. And now it's Dishira and Ramsey's up in this top lane versus each other. Oh, they get the Soul Catcher, but Mag is not going to be in range yet. Now he gets the Impale. But Darksteer's a very tanky target, but with that Dragon Slave on top of the Soul Catcher, Mag puts up the Carapace, but he's going to die to the tower. Sinego's still in the run, has no more mana, but Lil's not going to pursue. Has no more roll, and not going to get the last out on the Siege Creep. Oh, Dishira wisely goes into the Blade Fury after Ramsey's activates that Dark Pact, so doesn't take any of that Dark Pact damage. And then Ramses has to use his self. Oh no, Dishira uses his self. Ramses actually has no regen here, and he's just hit level 6 only now.
Regeneration.
Solo has a coconut, but not before he gets soul caught and disrupted into the LSA, into Dragon Slave. Lil is here with the roll. Solo taking quite a bit of damage, but they get the kill on the Shadow Demon. No one has showed up to this bot lane, and they're gonna get the kill on Snake, but they're gonna give it to the Dragon Knight. And no one shows up with his first dragon form activation. Oh man, he would have liked to get that arcane orb. I mean, arcane rune first, but he'll be able to use that for his next dragon form activation. As Lil actually aggressively moves in to steal the bounty rune, but he's gonna get punished for this. LSA, Soul Catcher, Lil's gonna go down. Not worth, but you can never really expect a 3-hero rotation to be at that rune. Top lane going in on Dishira. He doesn't have the mana for the Omni Slash. It got stolen with this Essence Shift, as there are 4 Essence Shifts on him. He has this Clarity if he needs to use it. Yeah, he's going to. There's a roll in though, and the Silence as well. They're going to get the kill on to Dishira. And Ramses doesn't even need to use his Shadow Dance active. So you can kind of still stay kind of aggressive up here. Seema gets another Soul Catcher. Sinego lands the LSA and the Dragon Slave. Lil on the run. He has a roll, but it gets blocked by Seema's positioning. Goes for the kick. Lands on 2 solos here now. But ultimately, Seema's going to go down to the right click of Seema. I mean, sorry. Lil's going to go down to the right click of Seema. Ramses couldn't have really gotten to that fight quickly enough. Unless, well, actually, maybe he could have, but instead he just wanted to go for tower damage.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
It looks like they want to go on Seema. But Seema places the ward, so he sees Solo, goes for the disruption, goes for the Soul Catcher. Solo. Not going to be able to get that kill.
We're here to say.
No one's still, he has Arcane Rune buff, so chances are he's probably going to look for a way to activate, or he's going to make an excuse to activate Dragon Swarm to get that reduced reduction, and it looks like the excuse is going to be pushing this top lane. There's a TP in, there was a TP in by Sinego, but it got cancelled or something. Whatever the case, Sinego does not complete it, now no one activates Dragon Form right before that Arcane Orb time, Arcane Rune times out, so it's a reduced cooldown on this Dragon Form.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
So they might go for 2 tiers. Someone needs to head mid to make sure that it doesn't get pushed in. And it's probably a good idea by Sinego to cancel that. He would have probably died if he stuck around in that top lane.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
We're doing a fair amount of damage on this mid lane, but I mean on the top lane, but Vega are pushing out mid in the meantime. Shira still hasn't activated Healing Ward yet. Are fortified. Radiant's middle this is a lot of structural damage to give up. There are four heroes mid, and only the Alchemist is farming another lane. Down goes the mid tower, but looks like VP are going to take this. Dragon Swarm is out. I think that Vega should go for TPs at this stage, but they're going to give it up. Lil isn't level 6 yet, Solo's not level 6 yet, Dragon Form went down. You are pretty sure that Slark isn't there. I'm surprised that Vega Squadron didn't go for the defense. Especially if G just like went in and put down an Acid Spray, I feel like that would have been enough. But they give up a tier 2 for a tier 1 mid. And now Dragon Form is up again. So they see Senego farming this out. No one is going to be going for an arm lift first item. I'm wondering what talents he'll be taking. I'm curious to see what the professional's opinion on DK's talents are.
What surge is this?
Smoke up on Vega. Gonna lead it with a Vendetta. But they go right. They have this Dire Ward, so they have Vision of no one. But this is a very, very tanky target. He has 3 points in Dragon's Blood. Ani Slash is up, but it's only level 6. They get the Impale, they get the Vendetta, but again, this is so much armor. Now they get the Soul Catcher, now they get the Disruption, but meanwhile, Sneko going down in the mid lane to Vegas, to VP. Regeneration. If only that Shadow Demon was in position sooner, they may have been able to get the kill on no one with the Soul Catcher bonus damage plus the Omni Slash. Now no one's gonna reunite with his team. May not even need to use Dragon's Form for this, but they might just activate Dragon's Form and then continue on to a tier 2. No one's holding on to it still. Yeah, they're gonna back off.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I don't know what Snake was doing.
You wanted out of it, didn't you?
I mean, maybe he already knew that he was dead, and so just figured I might as well force Slark to activate Shadow Dance, but I don't really think Slark had vision. He had this Radiant Ward, so yeah, he did have vision. Mid lane, they're going in on to the Schnitz Assassin. He's gonna... Oh, guy is so close to dying, but the Healing Ward saves him. The Witch Doctor right click is not enough. He's still in Vendetta. I don't know how they had vision of him, actually.
What have we here?
Ramsey's just been farming up Dire Jungle. Has his level 10 talent, Lifesteal. Well, Seema spots out no one, but no one has his armlet completed now, so what was a difficult target is the even more difficult target at this point. It is 24 armor passively, and then whenever he activates the armlet, it'll be, what, 29? 20... Yeah, it's changing all over the place. Yeah, whatever. They're going in onto Sneko. They just wanted to put up a sentry guard. No, I don't know what Sneko was doing here. Now Seema's here. There's no stun available, but the Dragon's Form transformation into the Dragon's Tail. They get the kills on both of the Vega Squadron supports as Slark pauses the game. I don't know why Seema showed himself. Like, what is the best case scenario there? Your Lina died. You see a Dragon Knight who hasn't seen you yet. And then you just... Maybe he got spotted? Maybe his invis rune ran out? I don't know. But Seema was definitely... There was no way he was getting out if he showed himself. Now Earth Spirit has hit level 6, so... I imagine that VP are going to use this Dragon Form transformation to take out the last tier 1 for Vega Squadron. Moving on up. Alchemist is going to have his radiance completed very soon. Actually, it's coming in on the courier, so he has it finished. 13-minute armlet radiance, very good time, so he's basically been free-farming. Ichira, going up against Ramses. The spot lane's getting pushed. Vega might want to go for a defense, and it looks like VP don't want to have to risk anything that they don't have to. While Alchemist continues to farm up. Gonna be going for BOTs next. And Ramses has also been quietly farming away, has his Echo Saber completed, and is actually going for second item Blink Dagger. Which means that life is going to suck for Seneko. He's so squishy, and there's nothing Alina can do against a Slark. Heroes who have ground-targeted spells are usually great against Slark, but for some reason, Lina just never really has the same impact. And the fact that Laguna Blade is... I don't know how often Seneca is going to be able to use Laguna Blade. Ramses going in. Seneca. Nice pounce attempt, but actually does not find Seneca. She just barely gets out. Silence up onto the next assassin. Stun hits two. Alchemist has 2 points in unstable concoction. So they're going for this push while DK pushes out the top lane. And DK going to be going for a Shadow Blade, likely into Silver Edge. The Vega Squadron aren't going to push it. People always make fun of the CIS region for going full Divide, but in this qualifier, I just really haven't seen it. Maybe it's because, you know, this is their major, right? This is the Kiev major. They have to do their region proud. If they make it, there's a lot of honor. So you gotta throw away those bad habits. I say that as they smoke up into the high ground. Ichira is going to get spotted, immediately goes into the Blade Fury, but he's just running away. Lil's not able to get the silence off fast enough, and Ichira gets out. They continue this push on the bot lane. It looks like, once again, Vega Squadron wants to defend it. G does not have his BOT. BOTs are coming in on the courier, so he doesn't have a TP right now. Tower's getting low. Lil is ready and waiting. And they have... Dire has this ward up, so they know that Lil's hiding there. And they're gonna get the tower uncontested.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Ramses is doing very well right now. Second net worth. While being basically offlane, Dragontail onto the Alchemist. He has Temple Rage activated right now, so it's a difficult target. Magnetizes use on top of it, stunned up, and Ramses comes in with that Blink Dagger, getting the kill onto the Alchemist. Getting 290 gold for that and a dominating streak. Ramses is right now 4-0-2. Ichira spots him out, but it's a level 6. Oh, no, man, but he goes in too soon. Ramses purges it off, goes into the Shadow Dance. He's still stunned for a little bit. Needs to pounce out, but not quick enough. Ichira gets the kill with the Omni Slash. Very well played by Vega Squadron. Slark had no idea that the next assassin was in the vicinity, so... It was unlucky, a little bit, but still well played by Vega Squadron. They get the impale. Slark's Shadow Dance entire duration is stunned, and then Omni Slash on top of that. No pounce out. And Ichira gets a good 500 gold bounty from that. Seneko actually manages to complete a Yules of his own, so maybe not as poor and screwed in this game as I suspected. The Yules makes a big difference in Seneko's survivability against this Blink Dagger Echo Saber Slark. It also gives really good initiation power, so if they find something like a Dragonite farming by himself or something else, I'll be able to get that kill a little bit easier. Snake still hasn't been able to use Laguna Blade a single time yet, but time will come. Top lane, they're going in onto the Darkseer. They get the Vendetta. Yeah, Posh is dead. There's no trickery, Darkseer. That was just a good old-fashioned gank. Ramsey's trying to go aggressive, but he's not going to fight anything. Dragon Knight has his level 12 dragon form, but I'm surprised he didn't go for Helm of the Dominator. I thought Helm of the Dominator would be like a no-brainer for a Dragon Knight, but not this game. He's going for a pretty retro Dragon Knight build with armlet, Shadow Blade, and actually not going for the full Silver Edge. Not interested in breaking anything. Radiant Ward. Sentry scouts out Mag in the vicinity, but Mag doesn't walk back into it. No one's hasted up. Immediately finds, goes into dragon form onto the Lina. Snuffed out indeed. Now it's time to push. Every single time you use a dragon's form activation, it's basically like every single time you use a warlock golem. You use it for a kill attempt or a team fight, but then you want to transition it into something useful, like a tower push. The Dragon Knight has 31 armor right now. Whenever armlet is activated, it's pretty great. He's not activating it right now. Possibly concerned about getting Nyx impaled and then like a whole bunch of follow-up damage. The Dragon's form does not have very much time on it, but like 15 more seconds. But they're gonna get it uncontested. Now Vega Squadron only have one more tier 2 remaining. Going in for a smoke on something. Vega Squadron has no vision. They have no idea what VPR up to right now.
What have we here?
See a few heroes in the mid lane, but they're gonna be invading aggressively. Mag scouting. Looking to see if the smoke pops on the trees. Nope. Not gonna find anything with that smoke. Now they're gonna go for a push of their own. Nope. Not even going to do that. The Shiro's walking around. I don't know if he saw this ward die, because if he saw that ward die, then that's actually pretty important, because that means that they confirm that VP knows where they are. Ramsey's staying kind of far back. Doesn't want to challenge this. No one on VP wants to challenge this. DK is off farming, and if Papa DK isn't going to help out with the defense, then that means you just have to give up the tower. I can understand why, though. No one now has this BKB completed, so there's no real reason to force the issue before you complete your BKB as the DK. It's just a tier 2. And Slark has 1800 night vision, so she needs to be careful. He's gonna farm off somewhere else. Solo spots out these two wards. Oh man, Pasha, you need to be careful. Seneca has his Laguna Blade. Nice carapace onto the Ion Shield to set it up. Pasha's a really tanky target. Seneca accidentally cancels the TP. He probably meant to use the Yules. But he might end up getting Pasha anyway. I'm just standing around playing with fire. They're gonna get the kill on Seneca. Oh, poor Seneca. I don't know if he had his items in the wrong slots or something, but he did not mean to activate TP at that moment. It was definitely the Yules.
Radiant's top tower has been denied.
What's the Alchemist been up to? finished his BOTs, finished the Mantis style, working on the Octarine core next. Oh, BOTs. On to solo. They don't have the vision of it. Oh, now they get it. Blink dagger by mag. Solo buys time, but only so much as no one's actually here. He's gonna get the stun onto Sineko. Disruption, unfortunately, a little bit too late. Now the vacuum in to cancel Mag's TP. He's on the run. Gets the impale, but not, unfortunately, onto the Dragon Knight, which means that Dragon Knight will immediately follow up with his BKB activation. Man, if they got the impale onto no one, may have been able to actually get that kill. Maybe not, but would have brought him close. Blink in onto G, activates Chemical Rage, Mantis style as well, but that just means that he's giving a lot of stats to Ramses. Magnetized used on top of that. G is ticking, and he's going to ultimately die. Slark actually being the one to pick up the gem. And yet again, another Dragon Form activation, another tower push.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
It wasn't the level 18 blue dragon, but for pushes, it's not that important. That's mainly important for team fights.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Oh yeah, so what were the talents that this dragon I went for? One for strength and one for damage. Makes sense. If you went for a Midas, then I can understand going for the XP talent.
Dire's bottom tower
and this
attack.
Game, he doesn't necessarily need to be the dedicated damage dealer. With a Slark on his team, he can just kind of tank up and force Vega Squadron to have to use a bunch of spells and right-clicks on the Dragon Knight instead of worrying about Slark. And now Ramses has a BKB completed of his own. VB is doing a very good job of keeping up in net worth. And it's mainly because G has just been, like, farming, like, the entire game. Shown up to a few pushes, but not anything, like, committed. Shown up for a few team fights, I guess, but never the ones initiating. Alchemist is great, but you need to do something with all this gold that you get. If you just keep on farming indefinitely, you're gonna lose map control, which Vega Squadron don't have any more outer towers left, whereas VP have a ton of outer towers, and they're about to have Aegis on top of that. And no one does complete a Silver Edge.
We'll take that.
We didn't have this ward, so they know that Alchemist is off doing what Alchemist has been doing the entire game, and Roche gonna go to the Dragon Knight. Oh, and a double damage rune on top of that. That's a high ground push if I've ever seen one. We'll probably wait until Dragon Form comes back up again. They're gonna let this Dragon Form time out. They're gonna wait for the cooldown, and then with this double damage rune bottle, they're gonna go for a push in the next minute. Vega are actually kind of pushing into it themselves. They get a scan on the solo, but he backs off.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I'll take that.
Slark has a point booster working on his, or Slark has that Orb of Venom working on the point booster and working on Scotty. Not too heavily net worth favored, but you have to keep in mind that there's an Alchemist on the enemy team, so the 6,000 is kind of deceptive. It's a little bit more than that. And Juggernaut, I totally forgot that Nishira was in this game. It's difficult to farm as a Juggernaut because BOT Manta and now the Octarine Core coming in soon for the Alchemist means that there's not very many creeps on the map. Ramses is kind of exposed here. Blink, no man, I'm instantly trigger-fingered, and actually turning it aggressive as they go in on Sineko. What was a defensive play turns into a kill. And now Scotty completed for the Slark. DK has his dragon form up. Double damage rune is ready, locked and loaded. Let's go for a high ground push. Alchemist is not even in position for this. His BOTs are down right now. He needs to sprint back. Double damage rune activated. VP are like, dude, how is this Alchemist here? Oh, smart Purge by Ditchira. Purge is a double damage rune. But immediately the back end of the wall, Shadow Demon just evaporates. Ditchira taking a ton of damage, activates the shrine. Laguna Blade is used, but it doesn't really do very much as Ramses gets the kill onto the next assassin. And this tower is going to go down. Ditchira does not do very much. No one does not care about his acid spray. G has the Radiance, but he can't walk through the wall. Otherwise, then Radiant is going to have a Radiance. And Ramses doesn't even care, he's just going in. Omni Slash is used, but it goes on to the Dragon Knight and it just tickles him. It doesn't even tickle him. It's like whenever you're tickling someone and then you're asking, you're like, why aren't you laughing? It's like, because it doesn't tickle me. I don't even care. You're trying to escape. This is the Soul Catcher on 9 Pasha, as well as the Demonic Purge. Ramses diving into the fountain, getting the kill onto the Shadow Demon yet again. He does not have an Aegis, so he needs to be kind of careful here. He's taking quite a bit of damage, but in comes the Coconut, getting some stuns onto the Chira and Mag. But objective-minded DK doesn't have his Dragon Form anymore, but he still has his Aegis. They take one Rax. Ramses has 27 Essence Shift stacks right now. Nice 3-man impale, but Ramses is too quick onto the Dark Pact. Sineko actually getting stunned out. No one getting kind of low. He still has his Aegis if he needs it. I don't know what that Laguna Blade connected on, but I'm pretty sure it was not the DK. Fuels up on Sineko. 2-man vacuum into the 2-man silence from Earth Spirit. Mag on run. Solo kills off the healing ward. And Slark is waiting. He's regenning in the back. Nice 4-step to get no one out of trouble. And down goes the next assassin. Yeah, Dragon Form is up again, so VP don't need to leave, but they're leaving anyway. What a push. So much sustain. Ramses has still 31 Essence Shift stacks, so he's gonna go for this shrine. Ramses is gonna go for kills. Oh, Sineko. Oh, they get the unstable concussion up, but now G is going in kind of deep. No one's ready on the back lines. And they, oh, G's going up on the high ground, but they're actually not going for it. They leave G alone. They didn't have vision? No, they have a radiant ward. I can't believe they left G alone. They still have the Aegis on Dragonite. They have an AC, they have Dragon Swarm, they have BKB. I can't believe they didn't go for it, but I guess they didn't really have any stuns. No one didn't have the mana for a stun, and Cask probably isn't reliable enough. I don't know. Oh, Radiant Courier goes down. Where'd that happen? Oh, in their own shop. Nyx Assassin. Classic Nyx Assassin. No one. Surging forward, activates Dragon's Form, gets the stun onto G. Yeah, it's a dead Alchemist for sure. Vacuum in on the Shadow Demon. Vega Squadron are just done. They're done. I can see why VP are 4-0, and I can now see why VP are 5-0. Very, very well played by them. Nothing flashy, but they knew when to engage, and that's one of the most important things to understand as a team. All five of their teammates were like, we don't need to go for these defenses, we don't need to go for these ganks, but we do need to go for these pushes, we do need to go for these objectives. And it was organized, very organized, and VP take a victory over Vega Squadron.